These videos on Illustrator are designed to give you an overview of drawing and working with text in Illustrator. Right now we're in Essentials. Anytime you want to change the workspace, it's available from the drop-down button up here. And you'll notice there are different workspaces for layout, which we'll look at later, painting, printing and proofing, tracing, typography, and the web. Essentials is fine for now, but there are a couple of additional windows I would like open. So under Window, Pathfinder, I'm going to open that up, and I'm just going to move that down here. Libraries is something that I'm not really going to work with, so I'm going to get rid of that. I want to bring the Layers palette up because that is something we use all the time. And it would be kind of nice to have color or color swatches open too, but for now this is good. So if I want to save this workspace, just go under the workspace icon here, go to New Workspace. I'm going to give it my name, click OK, and it's been saved, so I'll be able to access it again whenever I am in Illustrator. Here, I'm going to go under File, New to open up a new document. I am just going to go in and make a basic print document, though you'll notice there are presets for film and video, which we'll use, and web, which we'll also use, and also a preset for art and illustration. So some of the art and illustration sizes are very similar to the print sizes, but we'll just go with a basic print, make sure it's letter size, click on a horizontal orientation. I'm going to change the color to RGB color just because whenever you're working on images for screen display, you want them to be RGB color. And because we're not working with a professional printer, it's RGB color is fine as well. If we're going to a four-color printing system, then we would need to go to CMYK, but preferably CMYK with the profiles for the specific service bureau we're sending them to. So this is going to deal with drawing. So I'm going to call this example drawing, create, and I have my basic workspace set up here. Now in Illustrator, you have a fill color and a stroke color on the tool palette, rather than a foreground and background color, which is something that you would get with Photoshop. We're going to start with basic drawing, so I'll leave it on the default colors for now, but we'll change those later on. So it's often very easy to draw with shapes and connect them together. So I'm going to start by drawing something with simple shapes. I'm going to switch on the ellipse tool. And underneath the ellipse tool, you can see there are a number of different tools toggled. Notice that there is a hotkey to bring up the rectangle tool and a different hotkey to bring up the ellipse tool. And that's because those two versions of this shape tool are the ones that are used the most frequently. And often you might have to switch back and forth between them. So I'm going to start with an ellipse and I'm going to draw something very simple. So by holding down Shift as I drag, I'm constraining my shape so that it stays completely round. And I'm going to draw a pear, I think. So I'm going to draw a second shape there. Now this would be the top of the pear. This would be the bottom. You can go in and make adjustments to that shape if it's too stretchy or too squat. And now I want to line them up because obviously this one should be dead center with the circle underneath. I'm going to use the selection tool, drag around them. Both are selected. And when both are selected, the options in the tool palette up here show alignment options as well. So I could just click on this button and it's horizontal aligned center, so it's going to line them up. So now that they're centered, I can join them together. And if you remember, Pathfinder is the tool we use to do that, which is why I opened up the Pathfinder panel earlier. I knew I was going to need it. So click here and this joins the two shapes together, so now I have a single shape. It's relatively pear-like, but I'm just going to go in and make a few adjustments to make it a little bit more like a pear. So I have my basic shape. If I want to edit it, I have to do that by either editing the shape as a whole, and for that I would use transform. So transform scale, reflect, etc. And those are available under object transform, and you can see move, rotate, reflect, scale, and shear. I can also edit my shape by editing individual anchor points. And with Illustrator, what you have are individual anchor points, and you can see as I mouse over them here, you can see these are all anchor points, these little squares on my path. And these anchor points are joined by mathematically calculated curves. So one way I could edit would be to select an individual anchor point and then just kind of grab it and move it around. Now that's not going to do anything to help me get the pear shape I want. So I'm going to actually make a couple of changes by adding some anchor points. This is the pen tool. You can draw shapes and lines with the pen tool, but you can also use it to edit an existing path. And shapes are all made up of paths. So the add anchor point tool would allow me to go in and add a couple of anchor points. And the delete anchor point tool would allow me to delete anchor points. I'm not going to use that right now. What I want to do is actually select this anchor point in the middle, and I'm going to make a slight change. I'm going to use the arrow keys just to shift this up a little bit so that I get kind of a little divot at the end. And that, maybe just move it off to the side a couple of points. Now the arrow keys allow you to move something that's selected one pixel at a time, like this. Or if you use an arrow key with the shift key, 10 pixels at a time. So two different ways to do it. I'm going to create a couple of other points here. I'm going to do something similar. I'm going to create one there, one kind of directly across from it. Well, I said directly, but roughly directly across from it, and a couple more there. And then I'm going to do something similar by switching to the direct selection tool and just kind of dragging that down. So I have something that is a little bit more, you know, natural looking. I could also go in and adjust things like the curve or the position. So I could just kind of drag this out a little bit if I wanted. Drag this one out a little bit. And you can see when I have them selected, they give me these handles I can use to change the shape. So the direct selection tool selects individual anchor points so you can edit them without affecting the other anchor points. And if you want to only edit the curve of a specific point, you can actually use the direct selection tool, but you can also go under the pen tool, go to the anchor point tool, and this allows you to click on an anchor point and then use this to adjust the curve. Now, that I don't want, so I'm just going to undo it. Before we go on and finish the pear, I just want to point out that in addition to joining shapes together, you can also use the Pathfinder tool to create new shapes based on the intersections or overlay of two different ones. Just to make this a little bit easier to see, I'm going to change the fill color so we have colors to work with. I'm just going to create a second shape here with the star tool. So I want these to line up. Again, I'm just going to use the align tool, which shows up too, and now I want the star to actually be a little bit smaller. So I'm going to select only the star and use transform scale. Enter a value. I'm going to preview it so I can get a good idea of what it's going to look like. That looks fine. Click OK. Because I scaled it down, I'm going to select both shapes again, just to make sure they are aligned. And then I can use the Pathfinder tool to use this as a cutout. So I can cut out that star shape. So now the new shape I have is based on the combination of the circle and the star. In addition, I can also use an intersecting model to create a new shape. So if I have, let's say I just have two copies of the same circle, so I'm just going to make the scale uniform and 100% and copy that. And then I forgot to change tools, so I'm going to change to the selection tool. So I just want to create a new shape based on where these two intersect. So I can use this option here, and I have a lovely leaf shape that I could turn around and use on my pair. And that was a relatively simple way to do it. I'd want to change the color, of course. Now, we'll go back to the pair in a moment, but again, let's just use this with the rectangle tool now. I'm using a combination of selecting both objects, using the align tool, and then using the Pathfinder to create new shapes based on the intersection. So this one, the Pathfinder, doesn't create at the bottom. The Pathfinder is divided into shape modes and Pathfinders. The Pathfinders doesn't necessarily give you a new shape. It gives you a kind of a grouped shape. Like here, you can see they're joined together, but the two original paths are still visible. So if I wanted, I could select just this shape and move it. I've taken a bite or out of this shape here. So that exists in the shape of the overlapping shape, but this one still exists separately. So for the most part, we're using mainly the shape modes, but you can also use the Pathfinder modes, and sometimes one is more appropriate than the other. So again, just select both shapes and you can create intersecting options. Okay, so back to the pair. I'm just going to delete these. And this is a pretty good leaf. I just want to go in and change the color to green. And I'll change the outline later on, but I also want to rotate it. So I would go in and use the rotate tool for that. And I want to scale it down. So I could either use object, transform, scale, or I can use the scale tool, and that allows me to just kind of eyeball it and scale it in place, which is more efficient in this case. So I'm just going to put it where I want it. I also want a stem. I'm going to go back to the rectangle tool, create a basic rectangle, change the fill color. This time I'm going to go to swatches to do that, to brown. And again, I can go in and edit it using the direct selection tool. So that allows me to select an individual anchor point. And then I'm going to use the smooth curve tool to just kind of make that a little bit curvier so that it looks more kind of stem-like. And this one I'm just going to kind of curve this at the bottom as well. Okay, so here I'm going to put this in place. So maybe just put it down a little bit. Now if I want it behind the pair, I could do that as well. Just going to put that there with the leaf. And now I need to go in and change the color of the pair. So just select the color you want. I think maybe something a little bit more yellow would be better here. And if you want a stroke, you can change the color of that as well. Maybe make it a little bit more green. So I have something that's pear-colored, pear-shaped, and I've done a kind of a custom edit to change them. Here on the leaf, I think I don't want a stroke, so I'm going to get rid of that. And I could also create like custom lines here by using the pen tool to just create those basic. Basic kind of shapes there. So I'm going to use a darker green. I don't want any fill, so click on fill, click on no fill. And here I'm just going to kind of switch tools. So here you can see that's my basic line. And then put these little shapes in place. And again, I have to deselect. Just want it to be short. I don't want to continue it. So I'm just going to go in here. This allows me to curve as I draw. And there we go.